So let us see what is total production. Average production and marginal production. Okay. How can you calculate the total production? The total production TP is equal to summation of marginal production. What do you mean by that? The total number of goods produced, that is the total number of the goods produced by the given outputs is called total production. Total production is equal to summation of sum of all the marginal production. MP is equal to TP is equal to total. MP is equal to marginal. So if you add all the marginal production, you will get the total production. Average you already know. How will you calculate the average, girls? Total production by the number of goods produced, isn't it? If you want to calculate your average mark, how will you calculate? If you calculate all your total marks divided by the subject you have written, isn't it? The same way, if you want to calculate the average product, you have to calculate the total product by the number of goods produced. That is average product. Marginal product is additional unit of the production is called marginal. Additional unit produced is called marginal. That is, how will you calculate changes in the total production by changes in the goods produced? Delta N, TP by delta N. That is, changes in the total production by changes in the number. Let me explain you with the help of numbers, okay? Total production 100. If they have produced 10 goods, average production is equal to 10 goods with 10 rupees. 10 goods they have produced, the total production is 100 goods. So average production is 10. Okay. Marginal production, if you produced first day 20, second day 15, third day 30, இப்படி போனீங்கனா, then one day even fourth day, so this is MP. Marginal அப்படினா இது 20, இது minus 5, இது 15, இதுதான் marginal production. Okay. So marginal கிறது addition to 11. மொத நாள் 120 பண்ணிருக்காங்க, அடுத்த நாள் 35. அப்ப 35 வந்துரும். அடுத்த நாள் 30 பண்ணிருக்காங்க, 65 வந்துரும். அடுத்த நாள் பண்ணா 80 வந்துரும். அடுத்த நாள் பண்ணா 100 வந்துரும். So this is marginal. So the sum of MP is equal to TP. This is total production. Do you understand, girl? What is total production? What is average production? And what is marginal production? So if you know all these things, we will calculate the law of variable proportion in an easy manner. Do you understand? So today we learned what is production, production function, and the definition given by Stigler, and also the two things, short run production function, long run production function, and also we learned the assumption of law of variable proportions, and now we studied what is total, what is average and what is marginal. Do you understand, girls? Now let me explain you with a table. Here, units of variables. Okay, here total, marginal, average, and then last we are going to see stages. Average. Now let me explain you. Here I am using the variable proportion is labor. As I said, among the four factors, only one factor is going to be vary. The remaining factors are going to be constant. So here I am going to change the factor, that is labor alone. I am going to increase. Okay, the remaining land, capital, and entrepreneur will not be changed. No, there is no changes in the remaining three inputs. The only one input, that is the labor alone, I am going to do changes. First, I am doing the work with only one labor. I get a total production of 2. Marginal will be 2. Average total by number. So 2 by 1 is equal to 2. Second one, I am increasing the labor. Now my total production has been increased to 2. My marginal is 6 minus 2. Difference between this. Then 4. How will you calculate the average? 6 by 2. 3. Do you understand, girls? How I get 3 total by numbers. Then I am increasing the labor into 3. Now my total has been increased to 12. What is the marginal? 12 minus 6. 12 minus 6, 6. Then what is the average? 12 divided by 3. So 4. Okay. Then it has been increased to 4. Now my increase is 16. Marginal, the difference between this. So while it calculate the marginal production, you can calculate TPN minus TPN minus 1. Total production of the first column minus total production of N minus 1. This minus this is called MP. இதில் இருந்து இதை கழிக்கிறோம்டா TPN னா 16. TPN minus 1 னா இந்த இது. அதுக்கு முந்தின காலத்தை நான் சப்ட்ராக்ட் பண்றேன். அப்பதான் எனக்கு மார்ஜினல் கிடைக்கும். ஓகே, மார்ஜினல்ங்கிறது கரண்ட்ல இருந்து ப்ரீவியஸா சப்ட்ராக்ட் பண்ணது. சோ 12 minus 16 எவ்வளவு வரும்? 6. சாரி, 16 minus 12 4. இல்லையா? ஆவரேஜ் பாரு. ஆவரேஜ்ல டோட்டல் பை n. அப்ப 16 பை 4 is equal to 4. Then it is increased. Here also it is increased. And I am increasing by 18 minus 16, 2. Now 18 by 5. Appo 3.5. Varma? 3.6. Sorry. 3.6. Then I can be increased. Here என்னுடைய total production increase ஆகல. 18 minus 18 0. இப்ப இங்க என்ன வரும்? 18 by 6 3. Then still I am increasing my labors. What happens? It started decreasing. 16 minus 8 minus 2. 16 लंदे 18 ना subtract पना minus 2. So इप्पा इद पारे total एपड़ी कंटूटिपा 16 by 7. 7 2s are 14, 20, 3 7s ओरुमा 2.3. Now see this. Initially it started increasing. See the stage average parma. First it started increasing. 2 arundu, 3 arundu, 4 arundu. It is increasing. This is stage 1. See here. Aduthu rendum kittathatta ore maadhiri irukku. 4, 3.6. 3.6 also 4, isn't it? 3.6 naalum 4 nu dhaan solluvom. Appa indhu rendume common a irukku, constant a irukku. Idhu stage 2. Here 3, 2.3 started declining. This is third stage. So initially it is increasing, then it become constant, then it started decreasing. Do you understand, girls? With the help of the table, we can understand. If you do any changes in the inputs, initially there will be an increase in the output. After a point of time, it will be constant. Then in due course of time, it started declining. நான் சொன்னலடா, அது இருக்கா பரேன். Initially, it is increasing. Then it become constant. Then it started declining. So, this is law of variable proportion. So, if you bring any changes in your inputs, initially, it brings increase in the production. And at a point of time, it will become constant. Then it will become started declining. So, this is law of variable proportions. Will you be able to understand? This is stage 1, stage 2 and stage 3. This we can draw with the help of a diagram. Will you be able to understand, girls? So, the diagram I will give you in the next class. How to draw the diagram, I'll give you in the next class.